guys. Sorry about that. My internet connection is not working well, probably because we are all connected in the house and in the building. So I'm working with my mobile connection, so hopefully that's... Yeah, so we were on the chair. Apparently, the problem I see is you did it on purpose so you don't do a stretch on the floor. Okay? So, we keep going here and we try the third time. Yeah? So, we have the leg on the chair between the chair on the floor. The other leg is bending here, remember? So, we were here. Remember, the hips are out. Yeah? Connecting here, shoulders away. Yeah. Check that we are not tensing. Going like with your chest. Yeah? Expand. Don't force. Now from there we come back to the center. We will go to both sides, so it doesn't matter. We'll put one arm crossing on the chair. You can catch the chair or the floor. The other hand behind. We try to keep your body straight, pushing into the hips to open your chest, relaxing your shoulders, open your solar plexus, and we will rotate nice and gentle. We are not forcing it. Your breath is always the tool to know if you are tensing or not. So if you are tensing, it's because, if you are breathing tight, it's because you are tensing. Yeah? So we rotate the neck, relax the shoulders. And then coming back. Now, same leg, we put the other arm. Now, when you rotate toward the leg that is extending, it's less twisting that you can do. Yes, so we feet, hips really nice and rounding, shoulders away. We rotate wherever is possible, lengthening the back of the neck, expanding. We will go to the other side, yeah? So we put the other leg, again, hips tilting out. So you are on the sit bones, you are not falling back. If you are falling back, bend the front leg to be on the sit bones. Yeah? Expand. So from there, we put the hands, and then slowly we go forward, leading with the chest. So leading with the chest, yeah? We don't go with the head because that's round your back. This is not a good stretch. Expand. We go slowly, wherever you are right, doesn't matter. Yes? And expand. And then we relax. We will put one hand here, one on the leg. We expand, we rotate, open chest, shoulders away, breathing deeply. Don't tense. And then come back. We go to the other side. So expanding, shoulders away, open chest. We put the feet together, yeah? Sole of your feet there. We expand. Again, we try to go into the sit bone, and we try to do the same. Yeah? So we put the hands on the chest. We don't go with the head. We open shoulders away, and we try to go slowly forward, wherever you can, doesn't matter. And we try to relax the knee. We don't force. Soft, yeah? So here, or here, wherever is possible, relax. Soften, 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 soften. Right. And the last one, we open the legs outside the chair, yeah? Now, we can be with the legs extended, or you can wrap the chair with your legs. The more important part is again the grounding. So grounding into your hips to feel that connection, to have a nice posture. Okay? And we do the same. We catch the chair, we go with the chest, not with the head, no. Open. Chest. And we can put the hands here. And put the chin, not the forehead. We can have a coffee here. Yeah? Or we can stretch to the chair. Don't tense, whatever is possible. Soften. And you can relax. Voila. Now, we will move the chair. Yeah? And because we are already on the floor, tomorrow we will do a more gentle class sitting on the chair. Yeah? So, we take the chair out. Yeah? And we will put the same position, feet together, and we will lie down on the back. Now, if you need, you can have blocks or pillows. Yeah? So, we lie down. You have your blocks or two pillows. We lie down on the back. And we take our time to put the lower back on the floor. We open the knees again. Yeah? Like a C. We put the feet. I think we are all becoming crazy with this lockdown, right? So, we put the blocks beneath your thighs. Not beneath your bum, beneath your thighs to support the open of your thighs. Yeah? This is if you are tight like me. If you are flexible or you are soft on the inner thighs and you don't need the blocks, you don't use it. Yeah? So the intention is that you are not doing an effort to open them. So we relax. Lower back. Expand your spine. Bring the chin toward the chest. Lengthen the back of the neck. And soften. Relax your arms. Yeah? So your arms are expanding. They are not tight. You want to expand the shoulder blades. Yeah, we will work later on in the shoulder blades. So relax there. Soft. Let go completely. Now, in this position, the lower back tends to arch. So you do a little bit of effort, bringing the lower back toward the floor. The belly in, but not tensing the belly. It's more the lower back trying to go into the floor. So we try to support the position there for a few breaths. Relaxing. And then slowly release. We close the knees. Okay? Now we will do the opposite, okay? So we will put the feet separated like the width of your mat, yeah? And we will bring the legs, first one, so both knees are up, right? It's facing the ceiling. Now with one, you go to the center, the other knee stays up. Yeah? You want to feel like a nice relaxation, a stretch in all this area. Yeah? And then back to the center, and then the other knee to the center. Yeah? And back. So we relax. One. The arms are relaxed. Nice and good. And then the other one. Release. And one more time. And the other. The feet parallel, hip distance apart. Yeah? We will go to bridge pose. Now, remember the bridge pose? We use the feet, really important, to ground yourself. It's not only the effort of your bum on your glutes. Yeah? Now, the position of the feet is also important. So, check that your feet are not far away that you can ground yourself.
but also not too close that your knee is passing your ankle. Yeah? So knee and ankle, when you go up, more or less have to be on the same line. Yeah? So you press into the floor with your feet. We will strengthen all this area, but we want the support also of the feet. Yeah? We want the support of the head. The chin is going toward the chest, expanding. So the belly is a little bit in. Lengthen in the back of the neck. Expand your arms here. Yeah? So both arms in cross. Sorry, I have this here. And you can work a little bit with your shoulder blades here to spread more, to like a feel the spine between your shoulder blades, and then expand your arms again. Yeah, so all both arms. Yeah, sorry, I have the space here. Yeah. Next one. Go. And then relax, release. We breathe the knees to the chest, and we soften. From here, we will bring the knees to one side, we will go to a spinal twist. So, once you bring the legs to the side, open again your arms in a nice, comfortable position, shoulders separate. Soften. We want both shoulder blades on the floor. So, if you notice that the other shoulder is up or your arm is not touching the floor, remember you can put blocks beneath your leg or between or both. Blocks or pillows, yeah? So you can feel nice and confident. Now, imagine that we start to be open, more receptive to like a bath of beautiful, caring, loving, cleansing, healing energy coming our way. Remember the energy that we enjoy when we are in the yoga room. Imagine that you have that same loving, caring energy that we have there. I'm sending you now to your home. So imagine that you are surrounded by that loving energy. And with those open arms, you are absorbing that energy. At the same time, in this, remember when we do this spinal twist, this is a really nice soft one. So imagine that we are squeezing softly from the spine all the tension, all the stress that we carry. The spine is a support of ourselves, so we put a lot of tension there. So when we are squeezing, imagine when we are twisting, we are squeezing. Imagine a sponge, when you squeeze a sponge to take the water out, imagine that we are squeezing the spine from all the tension and stress. And then we go to the other side, yeah, with our legs. We soften again, check that you are comfortable on the shoulders, yeah? That you relax, both arms are extending, yeah? That you are nice and comfy. And then coming back to the center, and we go to Shavasana. So in Shavasana, remember a nice open position. Expanding your arms, nice and comfy. You can put a blanket if you want. Yeah? And you stay relaxing there as I guide you through the relaxation. Yes, yeah? So you relax nice and comfy, lying down. Put your blanket. Sorry. So from here, imagine again, bring back the idea of the roots beneath you, the planet offering through the roots all that energy, the energy of support, the strength, resilience, safety, security. Imagine all around you that loving, caring energy that is surrounding to complete you. And imagine that we will receive another flow of energy coming from to your feet. Imagine it's coming from my way here. Imagine that I'm sending you the same energy that we enjoy when we do the relaxation in our studio. So imagine that the energy is starting to go into your home, into your feet now, through your heels, through the sole of your feet, through your toes. Imagine that energy moving through the top of your feet, into your ankles, and then into your legs, your knees, your thighs, and your hips, your lower back, middle back, upper back, your spine. Imagine that energy moving through your shoulder blades, your shoulders, and then through your arms, your hands, your feet. And then imagine that energy moving back again toward your wrists, your elbows, your shoulders, the back of your neck, the back of your head, the crown of your head, your face, your neck, your chest, your belly, your hips. And allow your body to surrender completely to the floor. And go deep inside now and relax, relax, relax. From there we fall to one side, bending your knees, and we go to a sitting position, crossing your legs, breathing deeply. And now give a big thanks to yourself for taking the time to join this class today. And I thank you for sharing your time and your practice with me. Thank you guys for joining me. Thank you for the company. Yeah. A big hug, virtual hug, hug, hug. Keep safe, keep strong, keep at home. Yeah, stay at home. And tonight we have at 9 o'clock in the evening, we have a half an hour meditation, yoga nidra. Yeah, so we will do it 3 times a week. Yeah. So, and we will do different practice for go in and for relax and to keep the calm. And also, you know, to go to sleep in a nice mood. Yeah, so you can be in your PJs. I will be in my pajamas as well. So hopefully I see you tonight. If not, we have plenty of classes during the week. Tomorrow we have yoga flow at 10 o'clock. Stretch and relax chair at 11:30, and then in the evening at 7:30 we have a restorative yoga. Yeah? So plenty of classes to do while we stay safe at home. Yeah? Thank you so much again. See you later. I will approach the screen, so don't get scared with my face. Too close. Bye.